Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you end-to-end IoT architecture. So here, I'll explain you how end-to-end communication happens in IoT architecture. So in this video, I'll explain you in IoT system, how we have data storage, how we have data processing, how we have data monitoring, along with entire IoT structure. So let us begin this session with first point, that is things of IoT structure. See, IoT is Internet of Things. So IoT begins with things. What is the meaning of things? See, things means there will be devices that is there as a node. So in devices, there will be sensors, actuators, and smart devices. Here sensors are used to sense physical entities like temperature, moisture, sound. There can be varieties of physical entities that could be sensed over here. And based on physical data which we sense, we will be giving response. To give response, we are having actuators. In actuators, we can have motor, we can have valve, we can have LEDs. There are varieties of actuators which we use it to give physical response to the system, right? Here you can say things are embedded system in which there will be microcontroller, microprocessor that is interfaced with sensors and actuators, right? Now, whatever data that we sense by sensors, that will be given to next part, that is gateway. Let us try to understand how gateway functions. Here, gateway will be interacting in between things and cloud. So if you observe here, we are having gateway. This gateway will be interacting with things and cloud. So here next part will be cloud. See, gateway is also providing few functionalities. Like you will be observing, there will be real-time data that will be received by gateway from the sensors, right? So that data will be huge. So with those data, gateway will be doing pre-processing. And it will be doing filtering of data. And based on that, we can have reduction in data size at last. So whatever data that is being forwarded by gateway to cloud over here, that will be having bit lower size compared to the data which is given by sensors to gateway. Here gateway will also do one more thing. It will be giving command to actuators. So based on commands given by gateway to actuator, actuator will be giving physical response. Now next block, that is cloud gateway. You can observe here, these gateways are connected with cloud gateway over here. See, this cloud gateway that provides interaction in between gateway and IoT server. So here there will be IoT server which we will be interfacing it with gateway using cloud gateway. Here you need to understand few basic functionalities of cloud gateway. See, this cloud gateway that provides data compression. You should know, see here, sensors will be sensing real-time data. So that data size will be humongous. So here, if you provide data compression, then you need to have lower size of storage. So cloud gateway also provides data compression. Secondly, you should understand one more thing. See, this cloud gateway that could be connected with varieties of gateways, right? There can be so many gateways. Here, different gateways might be having different communication protocols. So here, there has to have compatibility, and that compatibility that will be given by cloud gateway. Now, next block, that is streaming data processor. So here you can observe this cloud gateway gives data to streaming data processor. Here streaming data processor that ensures that there will be smooth transition of data exchange in between cloud gateway and control application as well as cloud gateway and data lake. Here see this data lake that will be storing data in its natural form, or you can say whatever data that we store in data lake, that will be raw data, right? So streaming data processor is exchanging information in between cloud gateway to data lake, as well as real-time data sensed over here will be forwarded to control application, right? Now let us try to understand next block, that is big data warehouse. You can observe here we are having big data warehouse that will be taking input from data lake. If you observe by color combination, then you will be observing here data storage is structured one. So here, before it stores data inside big data warehouse, what it does is it does data filtering and data processing. After that, whatever data that we are storing here inside big data warehouse, that will be structured one. And this big data warehouse can give data in a structured way to control applications, right? And based on commands given by control application, this big data warehouse will provide meaningful insights to the given application, right? So here big data warehouse that plays essential role in terms of forwarding data to control application. Now let us try to understand next block, that is data analytics. So you can observe here data analytics will take data from big data warehouse, and based on this data, what it does is it will be identifying current trends. So with the observation of charts, with the observation of algorithms, it will identify current trends of given data, right? And based on that, it can optimize the applications, right? Here, job of data analytics, that is to give meaningful insight to given application. So based on charts, based on patterns, it will identify meaningful insights to given application. Now let us try to understand next block, that could be machine learning, or it could be deep learning, or it may be artificial intelligence, right? So here you can observe machine learning that I have interfaced over here. It could be artificial intelligence or deep learning. So with the use of algorithms in machine learning, we can provide some models. And by those models, or you can say by those algorithms, we can optimize our application. See, these models can be updated with respect to time, right? So here, with the use of machine learning, we can make our automation very efficient with given application, right? And there can be so many algorithms available, right, by which we can optimize our application. Here I have drawn a block of machine learning, but it could be artificial intelligence or it could be deep learning as well. Now I'll explain you job of control application. If you observe here, we are having control application. See, this control application will give commands to actuators over here. But how it will give commands? See, that command will be given based on programs that we are storing inside this control application. You can observe here this control applications that will be taking input from real-time data of sensors. It can take inputs from this big data warehouse, as well as it can take inputs from high-end technologies like machine learning. It can take inputs from artificial intelligence or deep learning, right? So based on these inputs, it will decide some parameters based on algorithms and programs, and it will give commands to actuators. And based on those commands, our IoT application will give physical response. Now let us try to understand next block, that is device administration. You can observe here we are having device administration block, in which we can have web application or we can have mobile application. You should know, my dear students, here you can have user login with device administration, or you can have network admin login with device administration, right? With device administration, one can have manual control of application, or one can have automatic control of application. That is up to user or admin how control should be given to given application, right? Now let us try to understand next block, that is user administration. At last, user will be using application, right? So you can observe here we are having user admin, which is interfaced with device admin, right? And if you observe here, this user admin can give signals to control application. So here in user admin, there can be two types of controls. It could be manual or it could be automatic. You should know, my dear students, here in manual control also, user can give signals to actuators. See, as if user is giving some manual signals in this control application, then those signals will be also given to actuator. So there can be manual control, as well as user can access application automatically. That automation will be done with the use of entire block over here, right? Now let us discuss about last part of IoT architecture, that is security monitoring. You can observe here, I have listed security monitoring. See, this security monitoring, that is very essential in IoT system. Why? The reason is all the data that is uploaded on internet, right? So that could be accessed by anyone. So it is highly essential that security monitoring that should be provided with given IoT application. And with respect to time, we need to update our security concern even. So in entire IoT structure, major challenges are there in terms of security, and that is what many industries are upgrading with respect to time, as there is a technological advancement, right? So that is how complete end-to-end architecture is there with IoT structure. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section, and you can observe our all the courses in comment section as well as in the description. That will give you more clarity regarding how many courses are available on our platform. Thank you so much for watching this video.